Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making shaker lemon pie.
I'm going to use lemons, two of them, and you can see I've already worked because it's a little tedious to get these sliced. Very thinly sliced, so they look like that, rind and all. So we'll put one lemon in, all sliced up, in this little bowl, and then the other lemon goes in. And that's going to be the main part of the pie. It will have eggs binding it together, and of course it has sugar that will be sitting on top of it or throughout it for a long time. And it's 2 cups worth, which it's needed when you put those rinds in there. So this is a 2 cup measure. I just used regular granulated sugar, and then you want to certainly mix it around. So that's all I'm going to do right now. I'm going to keep stirring on this until I get that sugar coating all of our lemon slices, and then I'm going to put it in the refrigerator, wait at least 2 hours, probably more like 4, and then I'll mix up the mixture that goes in a pie crust, and I'll do just a simple pie crust because we've done pie crust before. Here are the lemon slices after they have been refrigerated. You can see that they're nice and juicy, and a lot of the juice has come out of the lemon and mixed with the sugar. So this is a nice blend. I really only left it 2 hours because I had some other things to do and I wanted to finish up the pie. 2 hours is the minimum amount, and this probably will be pretty tart. If you feel like you would want to make sure that yours is nice and sweetened up, then leave it overnight because that's the preferred length of time to leave it in there. We'll work with this filling in just a minute, but let's get our pie crust ready so that when we get our filling finished, we can pour it right into the pie crust and put it in the oven. Now, we've done several types of pie crusts on Betty's Kitchen, so I don't think we have to start from scratch and do pastry recipe and do all the rolling and everything. And I've not done these with you before. You can buy pie crusts like this, usually in your grocery store, that just say unroll and bake. So I just wanted a quick and easy pie crust, and 2 of them come rolled up, and you have to snip the end of the container, and then you can kind of let these fall out and unroll them. So I'm trimming it. I can see I don't really have anything much to trim here, but I will come around here. Scissors, and that's the easiest way to get your nice pie crust ready. And how quick was that? It's ready to go. Well, let's move on to the making of our pie filling. We have our lemons sliced and refrigerated in sugar, and they were stirred a few times while they were in the refrigerator. This is a very simple recipe because it only had the 3 ingredients other than the crust. This is 4 eggs that are well beaten. So I just used regular eggs, well, jumbo sized eggs, but any kind of eggs you want to use. Go ahead and use a mixer and have them well beaten, and then put this together. But I think I've mixed this enough, so we'll just go ahead and pour it in. And if it seems to be too much, then we'll hold back on it. So I think I will kind of ladle it in and see how we're doing. The recipe calls for a 9-inch pie plate, and that's what I've used. So we're going to see how this fits in. And I'm just continuing to ladle this. I think I'll leave it at that, get that one extra piece of lemon out.
The next thing we do is take our other crust, because this was a double crust pie, and slide that one out. By the way, these come refrigerated, and you do need to get them to room temperature. If you don't have them at room temperature, then you can't work with them very well. They will be brittle, and they will want to break when you try to unroll them or you try to manipulate them in any way. So we'll unroll this, and remember, this is the top crust, so we're just going to try to get our full circle. And if it sticks a little bit like that and makes a hole, that's not a big problem. Just keep unrolling. And when you get that full circle, place it on top and try to do it in such a way that it gives pretty good coverage all around. And you can slide it a little bit And you'll probably want to trim the edges a little bit to match the other one.
This out of the way, I would just start somewhere around here and just go like this. Just press a finger between a thumb and index finger and do that all the way around and you'll get this little frill. Let me take care of that and we'll come back.
I finished making the fluted edge for my pie crust and pie. And one last thing I need to do, a couple of things I need to do, but one important thing to do is, since we've encased this pie within two crusts, we need to go through and make some slits. Just start at the center and use scissors and cut through the pie crust at the top. And then if you want to make some kind of design, you might want to keep this symmetrical. I finished putting the slits in my pie crust and you can see it's just a very simple design that I chose. You can do something with triangles or whatever you like to do. But that's kind of important to put some holes there so that when this gets really hot and starts bubbling, there's a place for that to go. If it's all enclosed there, then there's no place for the bubbles to get out. So now we've made a place for them. The next thing I do usually when I'm cooking a pie at a high degree of temperature, or I'm cooking it for a long time, then I like to protect the edge. And you'll see I have something that's called pop-up foil, and I keep this in my pantry, and you just pull one out at a time, and it's like this. And if you'll just cut them in pieces, you can go around the edge and curl it over very gently, trying not to mess up the edge that you have already made. And it will fold in on itself, so you can mold it fairly tightly there, so it's not going to fall off. And then for this next one, just pick up where you left off, maybe overlap a little bit, and keep going. So give me a minute. Well, I'll just tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go around this and finish that. I will put this in a 450 degree oven for 15 minutes. And then I will reduce the heat to 375 degrees and cook it for 20 more minutes. And at some point, maybe about 10 minutes before this should be done, or 15 minutes before it should be done, I'll take the foil off. And that allows the edges to get nice and golden brown. So I'll see you back and hopefully have a pie that is done.
I got my Shaker lemon pie out of the oven about 5 minutes early because it was getting very brown on the top and I didn't want it to burn. The markings that I put on the top to let the bubbles come up and steam escape can serve as markers, since I did them geometrically and I did it in halves and then quarters and then eighths. You can get 1/8 of the pie if you just cut along one of these lines. I've removed one piece. The first piece is kind of hard to get out. So here's our second piece. I'm just cutting down through to the bottom. And then I want to make sure that this is loose on the back, and also you kind of have to go underneath and make sure you get that bottom if it has any tendency at all to stick to the pie pan. Nice hole there. And let's move this over, see what we have. There we go. And I want to cut into this pie to let you see it. So I'm bringing it over here to my serving place, and here we have a nice cup of hot coffee to go with it. And if I were eating this pie, I would just be taking some of the end piece, but I want you to see the consistency. So let's just cut into it, and maybe I should lift this so you can see that there are still pieces of lemon that are almost intact. But that's pretty much what the pie looked like at Shakertown. And I haven't tasted this pie yet, but I'm looking forward to it tonight. I think I'm going to really enjoy it, and I hope you do too.